Hello, welcome to this new tutorial. In this tutorial, we shall talk about Article 26, Freedom to Manage Religious Affairs. Well, according to Article 26, every religious denomination or any of its section shall have the following rights. So these are the rights which have been given to every religious group, every religion in our country, in India, under the Article 26. So first, right to establish and maintain institutions for religious and charitable purpose. So the first right basically talks about under Article 26 is that every religious organization in India or religious institutions in India have given the right to establish and maintain institutions of religious as well as charitable purpose. That means every religion in India will have the right to maintain the institutions as well as to carry out work related to charity or for the purpose of charity. Second, right to manage its own affairs in matters of religion. That means every religion has given that specific right that it is their prerogative or it is their right to manage the affairs of their own religion or the issues or the matters of their own religion, and no state, no other public authority will interfere in the affairs of the matters of a particular religion, and whatever the matters of the religion is will be left out to that particular group or the religion to resolve. Third very important right under the Article 26, freedom to manage religious affair, is right to own and acquire movable and immovable property. That means every religious group in India have a right to own and acquire whatever sort of a movable property may be or immovable property. So again, in this right, state or a public authority will not interfere when it comes to owning and acquiring the movable or immovable property. And the last very important right under the Article 26, freedom to manage religious affairs, is right to administer such property in accordance with the law. Now the last very important right talks about that such property, whether it's movable or immovable, has to be administered in accordance with the law. That means in accordance with the existing law of the state. Yes, you are allowed to have a property in both the form, movable as well as immovable, but the administration of that property has to be carried out according to the law of the state. So these are the four important rights given under the Article 26, freedom to manage religious affairs to all the religious organizations in India. I hope you have understood Article 26, freedom to manage religious affairs, and in next tutorial we'll talk about Article 27, freedom from taxation for promotion of religion. Till then, take care.